Hi, welcome to 5 Minute Financials with Jack Driscoll. Invest 5 minutes of your time with me to improve your financial well-being. Let's start. Okay, there is a form of insurance that is a hybrid term and universal life. It is called guaranteed universal life. Now, I look at this as really being more like a guaranteed term insurance, and here's why. Universal life, as you know from my prior explanations, does build some cash value. Guaranteed universal life is a stripped down life insurance policy. So here's what we're looking for. Guaranteed term, and they don't make it. So if you ask someone, you go online and shop, or you ask an agent, I would like guaranteed term insurance. I don't want it to run out in 10 years or 20 years or 30 years. I want it to when I'm age 100, let's say, or age 120. So you say, why age 120? Because I want it guaranteed for when I die, no matter how long I live, not if I die before age 100, let's say. So that's the reason. So they say, well, there is no such thing as guaranteed term. So here's what the insurance companies came up with. Universal life allows some excess premium to go into cash value. Well, a guaranteed universal life policy is built to simulate what a guaranteed term insurance would do. That is outside the 30-year term. You say, what's the annual premium I need to pay? And you can pay these annual premiums monthly. You could divide them by 12 and pay them monthly. What's my annual premium? And can we lock it in that my premium's the same forever, for every year, so that it doesn't go up as I get older, and you, the insurance company, offset that by maybe averaging out all the premiums that you would need. So here's what they do. The insurance companies typically take and calculate what's your 1 year term cost, your second year estimated term cost, your third year, and they do that through age 100 or 120, and they figure out what the life expectancy premiums and mortality costs will be. They add them all up and divide them by that 70 years or 30 years or 50 years or however many years it is until age 100 or 120. Now, that's a simplified explanation. It's not exactly how they do it, but it averages out all the premiums for the whole length of the time. And a guaranteed universal life means they guarantee that premium not to change. And they do guarantee that life insurance to stay in force. So here's how they do it. That excess, what do they do with that excess premium in the earlier years? There is a small cash value accumulation account that grows, but it's only for the sake of ending up at zero. It is designed to end up at zero. So you're not going to have any cash value left. The only reason there's a little surplus or excess is to cover the additional amounts in the later years so that you're paying a flat premium account and they could take the rest from that cash value and deplete the cash value on purpose. So you end up at age 100, zero cash value, but your life insurance is in place, or at age 120. There's no cash residual cash value at the end. But that's like buying a permanent term insurance. So please don't forget to ask agents, when you're looking at a 30-year term policy, which does run out in 30 years, hey, can you give me the price on a guaranteed universal life, which is really like a permanent term policy? Maybe the premiums are so much higher you can't afford them, and maybe they're not. So you need to check both, and you'll be surprised at the results. Remember, it only takes 5 minutes to improve your financial well-being. Check back soon for more 5-Minute Financials with Jack Driscoll.